Hello, beautiful people. Good afternoon from South Africa. You welcome back to my channel. If today is the first time of seeing my face, welcome. Where have you been all my life? Thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate you. Okay, I will appreciate it if you can join this amazing family by just hitting on the subscribe button. It's totally free, and when you do, please do hit on the bell sign so you'll be notified of my subsequent videos, because I make videos regularly. Okay, and to all my returning subscribers, you guys are the bomb. Thank you so much. I appreciate each and every one of you. Okay, so in today's video, it's gonna be kind of an opposite of a video I've made on this channel before. I made a video that said Nigerian behavior I left since I came to South Africa, and some of my subscribers told me to also do the version of Nigerian behaviors that I will not leave. Okay, so in today's video, it will be like things about Nigeria that I will not leave, be it behavior and behavior and things that I will never leave about Nigeria, since I'm a Nigerian who is not based in Nigeria for the past 10 years. But these things are the things that I'll never leave about Nigeria as a Nigerian migrant in South Africa. I don't know if you get me. Okay, so basically today's video is about living in South Africa, Nigerian behaviors and things about Nigeria that I will not stop. Yes, I will not stop them, and I will never leave them. Okay, so without further ado, let's jump right into the video. Yes, so the first thing about Nigeria that I will not leave as a Nigerian migrant in South Africa is Nigerian food. Yes. Yes, in as much as I am a Nigerian who lives in South Africa, yes, I've been living in South Africa for over 10 years, and even if I leave South Africa, I'm no longer living in South Africa. I move to other parts of the world. If I do, I will not leave Nigerian food. Like, see, even if I begin to eat other food from other countries, you see, Nigerian food, egusi, ogbono, okra, rice, jollof rice, fried rice, ofada sauce, name it. Like, Nigeria has food, yam. Would I say Nigeria has the best food and the best variety of food in this world? I don't know. But for me, yes, I will never leave Nigerian food. I will never be able to live without eating Nigerian food wherever I see myself till I die. Number two is Nigerian attire. You see, Nigerian Ankara, Gene, different kinds of Nigerian attire, the way we make them and all that. I will never stop putting on Nigerian clothes, because I feel it's usually custom made, and it's made to fit you, to fit your body, to fit your attire, to fit your preference. Like, we have a variety of clothes in Nigeria. We have laces, we have Ankara, we have George, we have Isiago, name it, different kinds of attire in Nigeria. So you see, Nigerian attire, I will never live without it. I will never stop wearing it. Yes, I have loads of it. The third thing I will not stop doing as a Nigerian who no longer lives in Nigeria, who lives in South Africa, is watching Nigerian movie. You heard me. You see, my Nollywood movies, even if I watch Bollywood or Telemundo or American movies or South African soaps, Reading City, Generation Scandal, all those, I still go back to Nigerian movie. Because I love Nigerian movie. Nigerian movie reminds me of Nigeria. Like, when they act the village scenes, like, I remember being in my village, working on my village parts. I remember growing up, and it just takes me back home. So you see, Nigerian movies, I will never stop watching Nigerian movies. The fourth thing that I will not stop as a Nigerian migrant who no longer lives in Nigeria, lives in South Africa, is Nigerian culture. There are a lot of Nigerian cultures, that's a few of them that I've dropped, and these ones are the ones I'll not leave. Like something like omugwo, child visit. If I have a child today, and if my mother is still alive by the grace of God, she has to come. She, like, that omugwo visit, she has to come. Like, if my child has is getting married today, you see, the traditional marriage, you put traditional marriage, she has to do it. Like, some of the Nigerian cultures which I hold dearly in my heart, I will never leave them behind. I will never do without them, you understand? So I will never live without them, I will never do without them, I will never stop doing them, you know, wherever I find myself. Even if I live in, of course, wherever I find myself tomorrow, okay, I will not stop. Or the fifth is being part of the Nigerian community wherever I am. Yes, you heard me right. So another Nigerian behavior or something we do in Nigeria that is synonymous to Nigeria that I'll not stop is Nigerian language. Yes, I'm an Igbo person from Nigeria. I come from the Eastern Nigeria and we speak Igbo language. I can't do without speaking Igbo language. Like, I literally speak Igbo language to my children. I speak Igbo language to them. I speak Igbo language with my husband. When I call my friends, I speak Igbo language. And you know, I'm somebody that cannot stop speaking Igbo language. I can't just from nowhere, from the blues tomorrow, and I say, sorry, I don't understand Igbo. No, it can never happen. Even if I spend the rest of my life outside Nigeria, I'll always speak Igbo language. I'll always communicate in Igbo. I'll always, you know, behave like an Igbo person. Yeah, especially the language part. And I always, you know, talk. Anybody I see that is an Igbo person, I just literally speak Igbo to you. I don't want to speak English. So my language, the Igbo language, is something I will never stop doing as a Nigerian. I'll never do without it. Yeah. So I understand South Africans when they always speak their language. I just feel them. I understand where they're coming from. Yeah. And the last Nigerian behavior, something we do in Nigeria, something that Nigerians are known for that I will not stop, especially the Igbo Nigeria, is desire to make money. Yes. In Nigeria, most Nigerians will say that Igbo people love money. Yeah, I will say Igbo people love money. In as much as some people may go about it the wrong way, but the real genuine people that go about it the right way, they love money. Yeah, I love money, and I desire to make money, and my desire to make money will not stop while I'm still alive, even wherever I find myself. Yeah, it's my desire to make money, and that made me to study further, and I might still continue furthering my education, whatever it takes, not something illegal of course, but something legal. Whatever it takes that is legal, I will do it to make money. That is one Nigerian behavior which I will not stop. And yeah, it's popular. Everybody knows that the Igbo people of Nigeria love money. The Igbo people of Nigeria go into business. They try and hustle, you know. Genuine hustle is what I'm talking about. Not duping people or scamming people. You know, a lot of them are in the business sector, doing business in Nigeria and beyond. So yes, my desire to make money as a Nigerian, as an Igbo person, is a Nigerian behavior that I ain't gonna stop till I make that money. I've not till I make it. Okay, so thank you very much for watching. If you're not yet subscribed to this channel, what are you waiting for? Please hit on the subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, and tell me more anything you wish I should bring to you. Anything you wish I should bring to you in this channel, please always tell me. I really appreciate that. And yeah, those are the few things we do in Nigeria that I don't think I want to stop anytime soon as a Nigerian and as an Igbo person. Okay, thank you so much, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.